Hello everyone again. Welcome back to our online class. So, can you tell me what did you learn yesterday? Can you tell me what did I teach you yesterday? What is it? Alright, so yesterday we learned about being simple present in the book called Writing Right One. But today, according to our schedule, we are going to learn a book called Speaking Tutor 1A. So this is the book that we are going to learn in level 7A. On every Friday, okay? So the first unit that we are going to learn is school buddies. And the first lesson that we are going to learn is dialogue and practice. So this lesson consists of a lot of points like vocabulary, like conversation, like listening and exercises. But today I will specifically teach you about the list of vocabularies that you need to know in this lesson. Okay, so here as you can see on the board there are 10 definitions. And I will read all of those definitions for you. And what you need to do is to listen to my reading and then you try to guess the word. What is that word? And after we complete all of those 10 words, we will go to our exercises. So without any further delay, let's go to the first word. So here, our exercise today, write the words according to the definitions. Word number one. So word number one starts with letter P. And its definition is a small bag, usually made of clothes, sewn on the inside or outside of a piece of clothing and used to hold small objects. So can you guess what is that word? It's that letter P. So you have 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is it? Okay, you're right. Pocket. Okay, so now let's go to our second word. So our second word starts with letter D and it reads a white but not very big container open at the top that is part of a piece of furniture and that a person can pull out partly from its front to put things in. So what is it? You have 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Okay, the time is up. And the answer is, what is it? You are right. Drawer. Very good. Our second word is drawer. Now let's go to the third word. Our third word here starts with letter B and its definition is very short. A shelf in a bookcase. So what is it? You are right. Bookshelf. Okay, so now we have finished 3 words. Now let's go to our fourth word. So our fourth word here starts with letter U and the definition is boring, unhappy, or angry. So what is it? Start with letter U. You have 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. What is it? You are right. Upset. Okay, so now let's go to the next word. So our next word starts with letter C, as you can see here. So its definition is a piece of furniture or a small part of a room with a door or doors behind which there is a space for storing things, usually on shelves. So what is it? You have 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the answer is cupboard. Very good. Okay, so let's continue to the next word, which starts with letter D, a type of tableau that you can forget, often one with drawers. Tableau with drawers. So what is it? You have 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is your answer? Very good. Desk. Okay, so now let's go to the next word. Our next word also starts with letter D and it reads a book that contains a list of words in alphabetical order and explain the meanings. So what is it? So you know it. 1, 2, 3. Okay, very good. Dictionary. Okay, so far you have done a very good job. So now let's go to our last 3 words. So our next word starts with letter M and it means very angry or annoyed. So what is it? Angry or annoyed? You have 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Okay, very good. Map. So our next word starts with letter K and it means a piece of metal that has been cut into a special shape and is used for opening or closing a lock or starting a car engine. It's very easy, right? You have 1 second. Time up. The answer is key. Okay, so now it's time for our last word and it also starts with letter K like number 9 and it means the set of keys on a computer or typewriter that you press in order to make it work. So what is that? So you know it too. So number 10 is good job. Keyboard. Okay, so now we have finished all of our 10 vocabularies. Can you tell me how many correct words have you predicted before I tell you the answer? If you get more than 5, you did very well. If you get all correct, you are brilliant. If you get less than 5, no problem, you can try more next time. So now it's time to do our exercise. Okay, so now let's welcome to our exercise. So here, as you can see on the board, we have 10 vocabularies that we have just learned a few minutes ago. And here there are 10 sentences that we are going to do. So what I want you to do is I want you to look at these 10 words and then look at these 10 sentences, and you have to choose these 10 words to complete the 10 sentences. But now I want you to pause my video and I want you to copy all of these sentences into your notebook and then do it. After you finish your work, play my video and then we will check the answer all together. Okay, so now I will give you time to pause the video. Okay, so let's welcome back. I hope that you have already copied all of the exercises into your notebook, and I hope that you have already done it. Okay, so now let's check the answer all together. So here, look at sentence number one. My blah 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 is error. I can't type. So what is the word that we should fill in this blank? You have 2 seconds. 1, 2. So what is your answer? My blah 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 is error. I can't type. So what is it? You're right. Keyboard. Okay, so now let's go to sentence number two. So number two, I don't have any money in my 1, 2, 3. In my what? You're right. In my pocket. Okay, so just like me now, I don't have any money left in my pocket. Okay, so now let's go to our third sentence. Number three, she likes working on her 1, 2, 3. Everybody good? Desk. Okay, so now let's go to sentence number four. He knows lots of difficult words. It should be S. Lots of difficult words because he has a 1, 2, 3. You are right. Dictionary. Okay, so now let's go to our fifth sentence. Number five, my parents are always blah 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 when I'm late. So what is it? You have 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so the answer is yes, absent. So this sentence is actually true because when you are late, when you come home late, your parents are always upset because they are worried about you. Okay, so please don't be late at home, especially at night. Okay, so now let's go to sentence number six. I often or often, you can read in both ways, often or often. So I often put my diary in my secret. 1, 2, 3. Drawer. Okay, so let's go to sentence number seven. Number seven, I can't go into my house because I've lost my 1, 2, 3. Easy, right? I've lost my key. Okay, so let's go to sentence number eight. When I failed an exam, my dad got blah blah at me. Got what? You're right, got mad. Okay, very good. So now let's go to sentence number nine. I wish I have a blah blah blah. I have a lot of books. 1, 2, 3. What is it? Very good, bookshelf. Okay, so now let's go to our last sentence. Number 10, I would like to have a blah 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 in my house. So what is it? So here are the 10 words. Where is the last one? Here, the cupboard, so we don't need to think. Okay, so now we have finished our exercise. Can you tell me how many correct answers have you got? How many? I hope that you get all 10 correct. If you get all 10, you are very good. So that's all of our lesson today, and I hope to see you.